So guys, it's come down to this final episode of this whole entire campaign. You guys have been the best audience on YouTube. I appreciate everything. And hopefully I crank this game out fast enough for you. So I love you. Thank you so much for all the support. And here you go.
Stay with me. We're almost there.
Almost there. Almost there. It's not much further. Don't stop. Don't.
Come on. Cormac!
So what now?
Now we finish this thing. We're the only ones who can stop our hands from launching Manticore.
It's three of us. Against an army. It's suicide.
You're right. But it's what he would have done.
You got any ideas?
Just one.
It was a plan only Gideon could have come up with. A frontal assault on Iron Stronghold using the two mech suits we found back at the base. Drones would fly us in. After that, we'd be on our own.
Sentinel 2-1, we're still detecting high levels of contamination in the city. We will not be able to get ground forces to assist you. Over.
Copy that, Kingpin.
Enemy forces are closing on your position.
I see him. Mitchell, weapons free. Light him up.
Oh, shit. This is so fucking badass. Look at this. So we're flying on a helicopter. We're on a helicopter, but we're in these like mech suits. This is so sick. Bitch! Oh shit. I wasn't sure if he's supposed to shoot the boats or not. Well, it's come down to this, I think in the first episode of the series, I joked around that it would be funny if Kevin Spacey's guys, or Irons, is the bad guy. So, I just think it's funny how they brought him in the game to do that, which I think it's perfect for that. You could probably not shoot anything at this part and be fine. I just got back from seeing that movie Interstellar.
Kingpin,
so my mind is like blown right now.
2-1, be advised. We will be forced to strike the command center if you are unable to stop the launch. We'll risk further Manticore contamination, but it will be our only option. If you don't think you can stop it, get the hell out of there.
Copy that.
This is as fast as I could go. There it goes. While he was talking, I couldn't do shit. Alright, let's keep moving. Yeah, I just got back from seeing that movie and I just don't even know what to think right now. It's like you experienced some like next level shit.
Your point is up ahead. Let's move.
Gideon, thermal readings are spiking inside the command center. They're going to launch soon.
We'll make it.
Come on, go. This is as fast as you can go. You would think that I'd have sped this part up a little bit.
Mitchell, on me.
You This is so sick. It, parts of this remind me of Metro Last Light a little bit. Just the way this game, like the scenery and everything else with the water.
Ilona, we're inside.
You should be right next to the launch pad.
Security breach in the cyber. All units converge on Sector 4 immediately.
Swarm missiles.
There we go.
Rocket ready. Main gun ready.
Contact.
Just another day at work for these guys. To have a fucking mech come through or a guy in a, I would call it a mech suit, you know?
Cooldown procedure initiated. Rocket ready. Main gun ready.
I wanted to thank you guys so much for just all the likes and stuff you've dropped.
We need another access.
Head just down. You'll have to use the exhaust vent on the bottom floor.
Just on this whole entire series, I just can't thank you guys enough. Hopefully this ending does just as well. We'll just have to see. I know you guys have been just so supportive over this whole entire YouTube thing. Can't believe we've been doing it since 2010. I've come a long way, though. Glad to have you with me. And I'm sure next year I'll be doing the same thing. I'll play another Call of Duty. Just like that. After this series is over, I'll probably wind up... I want to hop down here. I'll probably wind up going and doing some multiplayer stuff with you guys.
Go, go!
For this game to be 60 frames a second, I actually tried to go back and play other games right now, and it just... I don't know what it is. I couldn't do it. I literally tried. I'm having to, like, wait until I finish this so I can get my first back into stuff that's not as fast-paced as this.
Launch in T-minus 4 minutes.
I feel like they took a page out of Modern Warfare 3 with the very last part of that game. I think it was Modern Warfare 3. I get them all mixed up. It's where the two guys dressed up in those armored suits and just walk in with light machine guns and just start wreaking havoc. That was like one of the most badass things I ever saw. I think that was that game. I know it wasn't Ghosts. Ghosts was like the space stuff.
Cooldown procedure initiated.
Come on, go, 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 go. Recharge, there we go. I really don't think I can die right now. I mean, I don't want to test that theory, but it's gonna be hard to, I think.
Launch in T-minus 3 minutes.
I hope we can get there in time. I don't know, like, is it...
Cargo loading complete.
ASD's ahead. Target the first.
Oh, shit, there's more of those guys. Now it's gonna be, us versus them. That's right, bitch. I'm gonna take these guys down first, cuz... Now how come I killed that one guy so quickly, but the guy in the back, I unloaded on him, and just nothing happened. Come on, go down, you dirty bitch. There we go. I had a lot of people ask me which shooter I like the best this year. I'm trying to think what all came out this year. We had Titanfall come out, we had Destiny. I mean, then we had this. I would say as far as the big shooters, that's what really goes. I don't know, like, I like Destiny for different reasons than I like this. This game is fantastic, so. I just haven't played the multiplayer. I'm pretty sure I would like the Destiny multiplayer a little bit better for right now, but I'm just not used to this one yet. So right now, we're just cruising along. I guess there's no stress in trying to get anywhere at a certain time, you know? Alright, bitch, it's over. Now I gotta follow him. Make sure I'm getting there in time, because. So Haven't used that in a bit.
There's an access point to the exhaust vents up ahead. I'm sending you the position.
Got it. Keep pushing forward.
Launch in T-minus 1 minute.
We gotta get going, Vince, while you're walking back there. I wonder if it's an actual minute, you know?
There's the hatch. Mitchell, over here.
Alright. I guess I gotta wait for him. That's what it seems like. There we go. Come on, get the piston! That must be some strong-ass just equipment, man. Be able to do all that.
Go!
Where the fuck are we going? Oh, shit! Oh! Fuck, there we go. Might want to move out of the way before he falls. Close to him. Treat this like a haunted maze.
Keep going.
I definitely upped the wow factor with this campaign, I'll say that much.
Hit it with everything you've got!
Ready.
Gonna overheat! I'm trying, bitch!
That's it! Mitchell, hang on. We stopped it. We stopped the launch. I'm gonna get you out of here. Stay with me.
Where's everybody at? So I'm just basically one shot. I feel like actually if you aim right here, it does so much worse. Yeah, I don't like that. There we go. That should be a headshot. Yeah, you can't even. There we go, finally. Bitch, get your ass down.
Gotta keep moving. Stay with me.
Sentinel 2-1, city defenses are breaking. Atlas troops are collapsing. We need to know the status of that launch.
Copy that, Kingpin. The launch has been aborted. Repeat, launch is aborted. You copy? Kingpin, come in! Elona, are you receiving? Damn it. Cut off. We need to move. They're gonna hit this building any minute. I'm setting you down. I need you to try and walk, Mitchell. Need to find some light.
Hello, Mitchell.
Don't you fucking move.
I could ask the same of you.
He's hacking into our exos! Come out of ammo!
You rely too much on those things.
City is falling. It's over.
What I have started won't end with me. It's bigger than me, and it's certainly bigger than you. You think I'm a monster? That's only because you don't have the conviction to do what's necessary.
Necessary? The attack on America? Unleashing Manticore? Killing thousands of innocent people?
I'm saving the world from itself. When there's no one left to challenge Atlas, there will be no more wars. There had to be sacrifices along the way.
Yeah. Twisted fucks throughout history have used the same argument. I don't know if you stopped the launch. They'll bring this entire building down on top of you!
I could have killed you in the prison camp. I could kill you now. But I won't. I'm not a monster.
Mitchell, try to hit the release on your exo.
So we're just trying to get the hell out of here now. So he's kind of like, I would consider Kevin Spacey's character Irons kind of to be like Magneto a little bit. Like he controls a part of Wolverine, you know?
Now mine. It's not working. There's no time. If he gets away, this will all have been for nothing. Go. No!
I'm just a basic dude now.
Don't let Irons get away!
Where am I supposed to go? Where am I supposed to go? Where the hell did he go? Just straight up, I guess? That's what it seems like.
Hurry, Mitchell! Keep going!
I thought I'd have to slide right there. Oh no, you don't, bitch! One arm on you. What you know about it? Where you think you're going?
Mitchell, pull me up. I'm not letting go, but you've got to pull me up. There's only two choices. You either pull me up, or this whole building goes down and we go down with it. Mitchell! What are you doing? What are you doing? Mitchell! I gave you that arm! Mitchell! I gave you a second chance!
Yours to keep, bitch!
Mitchell!
Had a feeling that would happen. The very first shot of the game, he said, that arm was the most important thing to him.
I've got you, mate. I've got you.
It was only gonna end one way for him.
Irons gave me a second chance, and I gave it back. He thought he could solve the world's problems. If he did have the answer, he took it with him to the grave. But he was right about one thing. This wasn't the end. It was just the beginning.
You know, I would have to say that I really liked the ending, just because what it was just like a, it was straight to the point. I thought there would be some over the top. Your mission at the very end was to just kill that guy, because Irons had kind of gotten out of control, and he wouldn't kill you, but he would run from, I don't know. I thought Kevin Spacey was a cool add-on to this whole entire story, but the story itself was okay. It was a typical Call of Duty type setup, where the, you know, the guy at the very beginning this closest to you is the one who you gotta take down at the end. It's stuff like that that you keep coming back for, but these games have never really put focus on the single player as much as they have the multiplayer, so I was surprised to see this campaign be that well It played phenomenal, 60 frames a second. It was the first true next-gen Call of Duty, so they had a lot to live up to. I know Call of Duty Ghosts came out on Xbox One and PS4 last year, but I don't think it was like a developed true for it, you know? I think it was kind of an upscaled version, whereas this kind of had anything goes to it. So I love you guys. Thank you so much for making this series a hit, and I'll see if there's anything after the credits, and if not, when I get a chance to, I'll show you some multiplayer. And that's it. You guys are awesome. Another successful Call of Duty. Another November. All right, guys, take it easy.